So we have problem 4, 3, 3. This is kind of a classic. I have a pendulum here, which has length L. And the pendulum here has an angle theta 0. And if the pendulum could swing freely, would swing freely, then it would go back and forth like this. However, there is a pin here, and this distance here is capital L, and so this remaining part is little l minus capital L, and when this string hits the pin, it goes around, and this angle becomes alpha, and it comes to a halt here. Let's call this point C, let's call this point B, and let's call this point A. And the question now is, what is this angle alpha? And let's assume we release this object at first at velocity 0. And then we will also assume later that we give it a certain velocity, V0, tangentially, either in this direction, or we'll give it a tangential velocity, V0, in this direction. Let's first agree on where we define the potential energy to be 0. It's completely arbitrary, but I would say that the gravitational potential energy, I would call that at point B, 0. There's nothing sacred about it, I just think that's kind of nice in this case. And if there is no loss of mechanical energy, there is no air drag, there is no friction, then I can write down the law of the conservation of energy, which then states that the total energy in A is the total energy in B is the total energy in C. That means the total potential energy in U, which in this case is all gravity, at point A, plus the kinetic energy at point A, is the total potential energy in gravity at point B, plus the kinetic energy at point B, is the total gravitational potential energy at point C, plus the kinetic energy at point C. Well, when we release it, if we release it at speed 0, then of course this one would be 0. When it comes to a halt at point C, this one is certainly 0. And so you can immediately see that the potential energy at point C must be exactly the same as the potential energy at point A, if there is no kinetic energy at A and no kinetic energy at C. It's at rest here, and I release it at 0. The fact that these two are the same means then that this point C is at the same height above B as point A. So this distance here, if you want to call it H, be my guest, must be the same as this distance here. And that allows you now to calculate that angle alpha. Because how far is A above B? Well, that's this distance. Am I doing that right? Point A, is this distance above? Well, this is L, capital L. And this is also capital L. This piece here, which I will indicate in blue, this piece here is L cosine theta. So this point here, which is the difference between A and B in height, equals L times 1 minus cosine theta 0. That's this height. How high is point C above B? Well, now we have to look at this triangle here. Here we have L minus L. And so this part here is L minus L times the cosine of alpha. And so what remains here is L minus L minus L minus L times cosine alpha. And the two have to be the same. So I have L minus L minus L minus L times cosine alpha. And I have one equation here and one unknown, which is alpha. And so I should be able to solve for this. Now the situation is different when there is a velocity here. Then the problem is a little bit more complicated. I would like to find my, oh, it's here. I'd like to find my original equation. Because now this value is not zero. But this value would be 1/2 mv at that location a squared. This would still be zero. If now you have to calculate the angle alpha, well, this we calculated. The potential energy here is mgh, so that is this value times mg. The potential energy in C we also know, that is this value times mg. You have to add to this one 1/2 mva squared, and so you can now, you again have one equation with one unknown, namely you have alpha as unknown, and so you can calculate the new value for alpha. And since this value is larger than zero, for sure, you will see that the value for alpha is going to be higher, and that's of course completely intuitive, because if you give this either a speed in this direction or you give it a push in this direction, it will obviously swing higher here. There is extra kinetic energy, so when it comes to a halt, the potential energy at point C will be higher than the potential energy at point B, and so it will swing higher. I don't think this was too difficult. What do you think? Let's now go to the next problem. We're still 1 minute ahead of time. I don't know how I managed to do that.